Welcome to Flirtardia episode 2. If you missed the first episode, you will find the link in the description. Okay, let us continue with the story. After spent 4 days making experiments without any sleep, Sleepy Warrior was a bit tired. So he went to the beach again and tried to do some experiments there. Suddenly, he did get a text message on his phone. It was a message from a medical company that asked if Sleepy wanted to be a part of a test for a new vaccine. It was a pandemic in Flirtardia, and Sleepy always took his vaccines when it was some viruses spread in Flirtardia. And if he would be a part of this test, he would earn more than he do in a month. So Sleepy sent back a big yes, and at once he took off to get to the center where he would get his first injection. When he arrived at the clinic, he didn't react to the fact that he was the only one there. He did get the vaccine, the money, and then he went home. But was this a real test of a new vaccine? Of course not. It was them. They had injected a tracking device into Sleepy's arm. At their control center, they could monitor every effect the powder had on Sleepy's body, and they could measure effects on his brain. So now they did in real time see the effect of this. The chip that they injected to Sleepy had several other functions. One of them was the tracking, so the aliens all the time could see where Sleepy were. When Sleepy arrived at home after the visit on the clinic, he at once started to do his experiments again and live streaming on internet. But after several hours, he ran out of salt. But we all know it wasn't salt. So he decided that he had to go to the supermarket to get some food and more salt. The agents saw this, and they sent Sleepy a fake message that he had super low prices on a special supermarket. It was quite far to this supermarket that Sleepy never heard of before, so he took his little car and was on his way. Of course, he was monitored all the way by the agents, and they had time to set this up, because this wasn't an ordinary supermarket he was on the way to visit. It's a setup. The whole store was rigged for Sleepy. Even the shopping cart was rigged with cameras, so they did see everything Sleepy did. All food he took was prepared with the powder, and they had actors acting in the shop and agents. For instance, this girl who gained Sleepy's trust and gave him some cookies. At them's command center, they noticed everything he bought and did. Dem was satisfied so far with the development. Sleepy had started to do flat world experiments and started to change his view of how the world looks. And now with the new chip, they had 100% control over Sleepy and his life. Also, the powerful organization behind them was satisfied with the results so far. But they wanted faster progress and they wanted to add more people that they can do their tests on. And they wanted to do tests in the big country in the West. Two of the powerful organization already had candidates to make experiments on. The old church had found one candidate. He already believed in their old book, and they thought he would be easy to manipulate. And the one they found was Breakdown Thompson. The space agency in the big country in the West have also found themselves a candidate. It was a man who believes that he is a commercial pilot. Bob Knödel. They quickly decided that this was the two candidates. So they made a wanted poster, which was sent out to all them agents in the whole world. And as you see, it was a small bounty fee for finding them, a smaller one on Nathan, and that's because he's always visible on social media. So he's easier to track down than Bob Knödel. Okay, interesting to see how long time it takes for them to get their hands on those two. Back in London, them started to get a bit worried because they are seeing clear side effects of the powder. Sleepy starts to be paranoid and he starts to talk about himself in third person. It's quite obvious if you listen to this clip.
Okay, now we've established that this is my own video. It isn't stolen from the internet as alleged by the ball haters that love to hate me more than they hate themselves. We can talk about some science again. Now, this is another example of relative density disequilibrium demonstrating that it is a force. And this is really important because if you think back to the egg floating or the cherry tomato floating in the water or in the fluid, we changed the medium and we made the egg move. If we move the cherry tomato and pull it up or down, it'll go back to the middle. And why? The question is, well, why does it do that? And the answer is because it's in a state of disequilibrium. Density is a force.
Sleepy was monitored 24/7, so the agents did know that he was alone when he did these experiments. How will it go with Sleepy? And will they succeed to convert him to believe in a flat world? You have to wait until the next episode. And will they find Breakdown Thompson and Bob Knödel? You have to wait for the next episode for that too. This was all for this time. Hope you will be back when we release the next episode.